Look who's here. This is Brian Keating, of course. We're talking beluga whales all through the eyes of our resident world adventurer. Brian joining us, as always, with tidbits and facts about nature, this time focusing on a beautiful marine mammal, beluga whales. Do they have a nickname? Do they have a nickname? Belugas? There's a song called Baby Beluga by Raffi, I know.
Yeah, really popular. I'm sure there's all kinds of common names, but they're known as the beluga whale.
And the beluga.
They're one of Canada's own. In fact, they're found circumpolar, which means they're found all around the Arctic.
Oh, really?
And total world population, maybe 150,000, and a good chunk of those live in Churchill Basin. And that's where I was with classic Canadian tours. We went up. Here we are. This is out on Churchill Bay just a couple of months ago in early July. And the pack ice was still out there. In fact, they've had a very good pack ice year, and the polar bears are still out on that pack ice. But one of the things that many of our group members did, we went out in kayaks and also in a steel pontoon boat, and we got very close to the belugas. Now, there's a mom and a baby, and babies were being born. That was an older baby, but the young babies are quite gray in color, and they're born in late June, early July, right about when we were there. There's a youngster right
there. So they're just a few weeks old then at this point, eh?
That's right. Yeah. Some of them are. That's right. And there's quite a size difference, obviously. Well, we got into the kayaks, about half the group did, and one of the group members started to just rub her hands in the water, started to splash with her fingers, and something very special happened. Watch this. A beluga came right over, curious as to the sound, I guess, and she had a whale.
Whoa.
Look at that. Isn't that incredible? That's a baby beluga whale, not new this year, but a youngster, probably last year's baby.
A teenager.
A teenager. And then I started doing the same thing, and Ted, look at this.
Oh.
It came right up, and it nibbled on my fingers. So I'm holding my video camera in one hand, splashing with the other hand. And then the beluga came up, curious about it, pushed my fingers out of the way, and there it is again there, coming right over to me.
That is incredible.
it was the most incredible thing. There it is again, rolling over. You can see its blowhole right there. You can see that funny shaped forehead. Look at the melon.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's where they make their sounds. So they've got a whole bunch of different calls that they make, because belugas are called canaries of the sea. Actually, there's a nickname for
canaries of the sea. I didn't know that. Okay. Yeah,
because they have a repertoire of some 11 different types of sounds. Clicks,
really?
Whistles, frog-like sounds. And basically, it's so that they can find their food, communicate to each other. But think about it. You're an Arctic whale.
Yeah.
You're a mammal. You have to breathe air.
Of course.
What happens when the ice freezes over? So, like, you climb a hill, Ted, to go and see where you want to hike to, to get a good view. They'll swim deep and look up from an auditory perspective, and they'll echolocate up to the ice on the underside.
To find a hole.
To try to find a hole, to find a crack.
That's outstanding.
Yeah, they're amazing animals. And the reason why they're in Churchill, and classic Canadian tours, they do this trip every summer. So if you want to go, just Google classic Canadian tours. They do it every summer. It's a two-day trip, and we fly by charter from Calgary directly to Churchill. It's the same company that does the one-day polar bear trips.
Sure, sure.
So, and then we spend an overnight in Churchill and get out on a steel pontoon boat, get out and explore some of the historical areas of Churchill, and of course spend a lot of time with the belugas.
That's outstanding.
Yeah, and the belugas are coming there to do what's called a catastrophic molt. So they're the only whale that rubs their whole body on the gravelly bottom of the outflow of the Churchill River, which is also rich with food, so they're also, of course, feeding.
Feeding, yeah.
But they rub their bodies and they get rid of all that excess skin, and that's
Exfoliating.
They exfoliate. Their body must feel like they got a full body scab. You know, they're trying to itch.
They're just trying to itch it off.
Yeah, that's right. And little chunks of skin come off and then gets eaten by the other animals in the sea.
Thank you so much for sharing with us again.
Yeah, you betcha, Ted.
Brian Keating. There you go. Good stuff. Beluga whales, beautiful creatures.
Canada's own.